Yeah, so that styrofoam undercover, they call it. What a nightmare to get that out without breaking it. I'm gonna have to do clips on this video because they're over there singing. So if you're trying to get the undercover out of the front passenger, you're gonna have to disconnect this because the undercover styrofoam won't come past it. So there's one 10 millimeter bolt that goes in through there and bolts it to here. Look at this floor, man. Sheesh. What a terrible job. Terrible. That caulk and a mastic, whatever they used there, they should have did that everywhere. Every one of these seams should have been done. But no, they got lazy. Look at it. See the holes? Any water gets under it can travel everywhere. It's all stupidity. I mean, you did some of it. Why not do it everywhere? Why is there rust on the floor inside? I mean, this is a 2015. It's not a 54. It's not a 50. It's not a 40, you know? What's going on here? I can see my little trail marks. See that dirty water trail marks? So it's obviously coming down, and it had to do with that sunroof. The sunroof drains leaking. Had to be. But I don't know what this is. Some kind of mastic they put here. Why is it cracked open, bro? You got to use something better. I mean, it's not even in direct sunlight. It's never in sunlight, and it's still cracked. Using trash materials to build these cars, man. Trash. Also, this floor ductwork here, you got to pop it up off of that clip that holds it. And you also got to pop this harness off of it to get it up high enough, because you got to flex this up to pull that foam out, because that foam goes under this, around it. Just to help you out, because if you got one of these with the moonroof, you're going to be doing the same job. You're going to have to rip the world apart just to fix it. Yeah, this car looks cheap. This whole clip here is multiple pieces instead of just one piece. Yeah, well, it's technically one piece and then fold it. Them little tacks that never last. Oh, man. You clearly see where we're headed with technology. It's all about profit. It's all about laziness. More profit. No quality. I mean, quality costs money. They want all the money and profit, these manufacturers. Spending too much time with Satan. Life's not about money. Money is a tool to get you through life. That's all it is. So I got myself a little bucket of cleaner, a rag. I'm wiping down everything I can. I gotta clean this all up. I gotta get in all these nooks and crannies. The reason why is when you have fungus like this in here and you open and close the door, it's grabbing on the rubber insulation and pulling it. So you see this? That's no good. But that's another cheesy Nissan design. But I saw another one where it's actually pulling the rubber off. I think it's this one here. See that fungus? I gotta get that off of there. Because it's doing this. When you open and close the door, it's pulling the cheesy clips, the Fisher-Price chip clips that they put in there. It's pulling them right out. This one's totally missing. See, there's a spot there for a little clip, and there's no clip. I mean, this rubber's doing nothing if it's loose. It needs to be connected. Look at this. Come on, man. Look at this. All the clips came out, little cheesy Fisher-Price clips. I mean, they used to build toys better than this car's been built. It's crazy. So I gotta get all this fungus off of here. Look at this. That's a broken clip there. And yesterday, in the video I did yesterday on this car, I started blaming myself for breaking those poles. Well, no, I thought about it. They had to cut this out. This whole piece came off. And they had to weld a new one in. So they took these seats out. They broke the clips. So, I mean, I shouldn't be blaming myself for something I didn't do. I'm going to to get to wiping. I'm just gonna have to keep doing clips because of these people over here. I mean, let's say I had all the money in the world, then what? If I ran into this problem with mold in this car, what would I do? Pay somebody else to fix it? What am I gonna learn then? I can't learn anything unless I do it myself. If I had all the money in the world, I wouldn't learn anything. I would think I know everything already. I'm better than everybody else, because this is what the rich think. They think they're better than you. They know everything. You don't know anything. You couldn't do this, bro. You'd have broke the seat trying to take it out with all your money. So I just spent about an hour, $2 of dirty water, just doing an initial clean. I did all around the door jams, just to get most of the fungus off. I got in there as best as I could. I mean, it's a lot of work. So I think I figured out what the rust is. So the rust, looking at it, it seems to me that when that Toyota dealer had this car fixing it, cutting this pillar out, they had the whole interior out. They took everything out, the carpet, everything. Because how'd this get ripped? How'd you rip that, bud? I mean, that is under the seat. The seat's always in, so it's not from a person. So they must have took all this out, and they were grinding, cutting this out. And those are the grinding pieces, you know, the little metal pieces. Because I just pulled some puddles of it out. You know, there's like puddles of the metal shavings with the rag. So that's what that is. It must have been laying there. Then as the water came in from the sunroof, it rusted it. But I mean, this is a mess, man. Well, gotta keep going. Did the back door. I did in this jam as best I could. I mean, it's not exactly easy. Whoever designed this is not a clean person. Doesn't think clean, think about easy access to clean it. There's too much stuff in the way. I see, you know, professional detail. They got little paintbrushes and stuff. But, man, you shouldn't have to do all that. You should be able to wipe stuff down with a rag. You shouldn't have to get your car detailed every single week. Man. Can't get this rubber thing off. I'm going to try to get it off later. It's from this rubber. But I did wipe it all down as best I could. Of course, as I reassemble, I'm gonna have to do some more cleaning. And after it's all assembled, I'll probably do a thorough cleaning again with it assembled. But you know, you can only do so much when it's assembled. That's why I'm trying to get what I can get now. So I think I'm gonna clean the carpets next. Get this passenger, you know, just on the passenger side, because I did the driver's side already. And then I gotta pull it in here. I'm gonna back it in and I'm gonna hug that wall. This way I have room over here to do the driver's side. I have to, you know, wipe down the doors and stuff. Probably take that driver's seat out, get it ready for reassembly once all the parts dry. Let's see what we got in here. This is the evacuation tank here. This is where all the trash goes. Smells like dead cabbage. Mold, mildew. I'd rather it in there than in there. Yup, you're lucky you can't smell it. Let's see it. Not too bad. I've done worse. Carpets in people's houses. Thank you.